Now, when we graduated, then Barack Obama was, in my opinion, the number one graduate in our class. There were 4 magna cum laude graduates. There hadn't been a summa cum laude graduate at Harvard Law School for 30 years, and there wasn't one argument. There were 4 magna cum laude graduates. There were about 25 or 30 cum laude graduates, of which I was one. And then there were the stupid people. I'm kidding. But so, what's interesting about that, and you all would know this, is that even if you are in that thank you laude crew, even if you're the last graduate from Harvard Law School in the thank you laude group, you're still offered a wonderful 6-figure salary paying jobs and opportunities to clerk for different courts because you graduated from Harvard Law School, let alone if you are the president of the Harvard Law Review, the top position to get as a student, as well as one of the 4 magna cum laude graduates. So in my opinion, since the then Barack Obama was all of those things, he was the number one student coming out of our class. And what's interesting about this is that there's a great deal of revisionist history, but most people, this is 20 years ago, thought that he was crazy at the time. Why? Because he was choosing to follow his core, his heart, and go back to Chicago and go help people and turn down all of this newfound opportunity that he had as the top graduate. What do I mean by that newfound opportunity? I mean the opportunity to clerk for the appellate or Supreme Court, which is the natural progression of someone who is graduating at the top of their class from a top law school. That's what you do. You take the next opportunity and it sets you up for the next, and sets you up for the next. At least that's what we're told by other people projecting their false evidence of superior real onto us. And it's very few of us that are able to allow and hear all this projection all the time, but stay on our own purpose or mission. And when I graduated, you know, I was going to become an actor, I can't even tell you what they said about me. They thought he was kind of odd, but they thought I was actually a lunatic. But I was following my core, my heart. And it's very easy for us to get pulled off purpose, particularly those of us as black men and black women, because just look at some of the data. We've been pulled off course.